Half a million residents in the province of Occidental Mindoro enduring blackouts for up to 20 hours a day. As Dennis Dato reports, residents are starting to get sick amid the worsening power crisis.
The electricity crisis in the province of Occidental Mindoro continues to worsen. Over half a million residents have been experiencing 20-hour blackouts daily for almost 2 months now. In the town of Pamburao, students of Occidental Mindoro National High School complain that the hot weather is affecting their studies. In this grade 10 class, 12 students were absent after getting sick due to the extreme heat.
Hindi sila makapag-concentrate sa pakikinig sa aming mga guro. Yung iba po, merong mga hika, nahihirapang huminga. Sobrang ang sakit-sakit po ng ulo na rin ng mga bata. Ilan beses na po na may dinala po kami sa nurse, sa clinic.
Even the teachers struggle with the high temperature.
Sobra po sir, hirap na po kami. Kasi sa totoo lang sir, hindi lang sa pagtuturo ang apektado sa kalapati-ipat aming pamumuhay na ano na rin sir, affected na rin. Kasi hindi na rin makatulad po ng aming mga kasama sa bahay. Hindi na po sila makakilos dahil sa sobrang puya.
In the town of San Jose, 11 high school and college students from different schools were given first aid after experiencing dizziness and losing consciousness while in class. The municipal disaster office blames the excessive heat following a power outage. Based on the record of the DepEd Occidental Mindoro, 145 students experienced headache, dizziness, and difficulty of breathing associated with the weather starting last month. This prompted DepEd Occidental Mindoro to adjust the class schedule.
Ang payo po namin talaga ay huwag i-contain ang bata sa paaralan sa in between 10:30 hanggang 2:30 kasi yun yung time na sobrang init sa mga paaralan. Ang proposal nga po ng ilan nating principal as early as 6 o'clock dahil high school daw naman, pwede na silang mag-start hanggang 10:30. Tapos sa hapon po ay 3:30 hanggang 6:30.
Governor Eduardo Gadiano is appealing to President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. to help them resolve the power crisis.
O yun nga yung panawagan lang natin sa Pangulo ay mamagitan na sa problemang ito. Ito ay decade ng problema itong kon na ito, tungkol sa kuryente ito. Baka sa panahon ni Presidente ay maayos yung problemang ito. Anong kampanya, nabanggit niya yung usapin ng kuryente rito sa Occidental at sabi niya iaayusin.
The province of Occidental Mindoro has already been placed under a state of calamity. Last Saturday, several protests were held to call for a solution to the power crisis in the province. Power provider OMCPC can only supply 12 megawatts to power distributor Umeco, falling short of the province's requirement of 30 megawatts. OMCPC said they could supply 20 megawatts more, but only if provisional authority is given by the Energy Regulatory Commission or ERC and if NAPCOR provides them with a subsidy to purchase fuel which will be used to run the plant.
In our books, MPC owes us 1 billion. So books the MPC, they owe us 400 million. But if they will allow us to operate more than 12 megawatts, now fuel pass through and NPC pays on time and according to our computation, or at least break even kami, wala tayong problemang ganito because the capacity is there. May 20 megawatts sa San Jose, may 6 megawatts sa Sablayan, at may 9 megawatts sa Mamburao.
Umeco says they will now get additional power supply from Umeco of Oriental Mindoro after the Department of Energy allowed them to enter a contract for a 17-megawatt power supply without going through bidding.
Ang problema lang dito, during off-peak lang namin dito pwedeng makuha. Yung off-peak, yung oras na mababa na yung load. So meron kaming pwedeng makuha na hanggang 4 megawatts o hanggang 6 megawatts.
So kulang pa rin.
Kulang pa rin po yun at meron po kaming kinukontrata ngayon na 5 megawatts na nandyan sa pulang lupa o sa barangay central na 5 megawatts at pinag-uusapan na po yung terms ng kontrata.
The DOE is confident the power supply will increase to 8 hours from the current 4 hours daily with the help of the additional generator. But with the restoration of normal power supply still uncertain, the province's over 500,000 residents will continue to suffer. That is Dato, ABS-CBN News, Occidental, Mindoro.
The Philippine government is urging the owner of sunken MT Princess Empress RDC Railed Marine Services to siphon the remaining oil from the tanker. The Office of Civil Defense said draining the excess oil, which may take at least 2 months, will prevent further damage caused by the oil slick. Over 37,000 households and 103 areas have been affected by the oil spill off Oriental Mindoro, while the cost of damage has hit 3.7 billion pesos.
Sabihin po natin, wala po tayong sariling equipment. Nung siphoning machine, hindi po atin yon. Yan po ikokontrata nung private sector, yung po nakagawa nitong aksidente. Nagkiklaim sila sa insurance nila para magkaroon ng mobilization, contracting. Sila po ang gagastos po doon. Pangalawang maaaring suliranin na sana ay huwag mangyari kung po magkakaroon ng mas maagang mga bagyo. Kasi yan pong lugar na yan, oo, sobra pong lakas ng adon.
The Vice Governor of the now defunct Maguindanao Province maintains she is the legitimate leader of the newly created Maguindanao del Norte Province. This as she rejects President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s move of appointing her as Vice Governor and officer in charge of the new province. Sinsuwat argues the law that split Maguindanao into two political territories makes her the governor of one of the two provinces. She adds she did not receive any communication from Malacañang about the political changes in the province. Sinsuwat broke her silence days after Marcos appointed former Bangsamoro Senior Minister Abdul Rauf Macacua as Maguindanao del Norte OIC governor. Now, driver's licenses in the Philippines will be printed on paper for now. The Land Transportation Office cites a thinning supply of plastic cards across the offices nationwide. It says its current stock of plastic cards, which is now only at 147,000, is expected to last until the end of the month. LTO Chief Jose Arturo Tugade explains the low supply can be attributed to an order barring the agency from engaging in any procurement activity that will exceed 50 million pesos.
Had we been able to continue with our procurement activities, we would have sufficient plastic cards. We wrote them and we said we cannot afford any delays in the procurement of the plastic cards, and maybe they might want to reconsider the SO. But we didn't stop there. We kept on trying to convince them.
Philippine government agencies begin their probe into the alleged massive data leak of employee and citizen records. The ICT department called the issue a grave concern. The Philippine National Police also looking into the matter.
The data breach is being investigated by our ACG. So we just have to wait.
As for Bureau of Internal Revenue Commissioner Romeo Lumagi Jr., he asserts the leak did not happen in his agency. The Philippine Privacy Commission, meanwhile, says there is no concrete evidence yet that 1.2 million records from different agencies were leaked. It, however, agreed with the findings of VPN mentor cybersecurity researcher Jeremiah Fowler, who said the government data are unprotected.
As Mr. Fowler claimed, he saw the database was not password protected. Mm-hmm. By using an IoT scanner. So he found that it was exposed, but he is not sure if someone downloaded the entire database. At this point in the investigation, we're not sure that an unauthorized person got the or managed to download the entire database. So right now, what we have for Mr. Fowler is that the database was left exposed.
The NPC is set to conduct an on-site investigation on the data processing system of the PNP on Monday. The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department now gearing up to repatriate affected Filipino workers in Sudan. The evacuation will be carried out by land as airports in the country remain closed amid fighting between government and paramilitary troops. At least one Filipino has been reported hurt after getting hit by a stray bullet. DFA Undersecretary Eduardo De Vega said the victim is now in stable condition. There are around 400 Filipinos in Sudan.
Problem nga lang, hindi sila mauwi because there's no flights. The embassy is planning to send a team, they call a rapid response team. We're working with the Americans to check kung merong land transportation to drive them from Khartoum, the capital of Sudan, to Egypt.
Filipinos in need of help there can reach out to the contact details flashed on your screen. Filipino Muslims will observe Eid al-Fitr for the feast of the breaking of the fast on Saturday, that's April 22, tomorrow. That's according to the Bangsamoro Mufti, after not sighting the moon crescent on Thursday. The sighting of the moon crescent is crucial in determining Eid al-Fitr, which marks the end of Ramadan or the month of fasting. Earlier, Malacanang declared Friday, April 21st, as a holiday for the observance of the end of Ramadan. Meanwhile, President Ferdinand Marcos expresses solidarity with the Muslim community ahead of the celebration of Eid al-Fitr. He also urges Filipinos to remain united, regardless of religion